Hello everybody, Fiasco here from Disney's Magic Kingdom. Here to tell you what's up at Magic Kingdom for the week of January 11th, 2021. Before we get started, let me let you know, all these videos are brought to you by dreamsunlimitedtravel.com. Let our travel experts help you plan that next vacation. All that info and more in the description below, but let's go check out what's up at Magic Kingdom.
So the obvious first thing, the elephant in the outdoors or the elephant in the room, is the front drop here for the train station, obviously doing some work there. So we can't see the actual station. And then also we still have Christmas decor up as of halfway through the second week of January. And that's the case throughout all the parks right now. So working our way through Main Street now, like I mentioned, Christmas decor still in full swing. But one thing that I definitely want to point out is how tame these crowds are, or should I say lack of crowds, the absence of crowds. As far as Main Street's concerned right now, as we first walked in at around noon today on a Monday, it looks really good, really, really good. But our first land we're going to stop in is actually going to be Tomorrowland. So here is our first look into Tomorrowland, and as you can see, what a beautiful sight to behold. Just a few weeks ago, this was bumping with Christmas crowds, but now look at it. Open as the eye can see. And as you can see up top there, the People Mover vehicles. The People Mover were shut down for refurbishment back in March 2020. It is nearing that completion though. And we expect for this ride to be open very, very soon. We hope that this ride is open very, very soon, because it's one of my favorites. And it's over the past couple years, it's gained a lot of traction and a lot of popularity. It has become a serious fan fave here at the Magic Kingdom. So I'm glad that it got a refurbishment, because it obviously tells us they're not going the route of Disneyland People Mover. They're putting money into this. They're redoing the track. So that's only good news. So Space Mountain was a 40-minute wait, and I'm heading to Fantasyland now to see what the wait time for all those rides are. As we're crossing through Tomorrowland Speedway, a little bit more of a concentration of people than we've seen so far, but still pretty low amounts of people. And we'll see what Tomorrowland Speedway says right now. Does it say 5 minutes? I believe. Yep. 5 minutes. Before we head into Fantasyland though, let's get some angle looks at the Tron construction. So we can see some track here from the Speedway. But our best view is gonna definitely be over behind the Barnstormer. Passing by Big Top, if you didn't know, it is currently closed. It has been for a little bit now. And we're gonna keep moseying on through over to our view of the Tron construction. Looking at Barnstormer, it is at a 25 minute wait, or at least that's what it says. So this is actually the closest that we can get to views of the Tron construction right now, because of the Barnstormer line and how it's wrapping through. It's taking up that whole space we would normally walk down and see. So this is the look. You can see it's all boxed up. It's been enclosed like that for a bit now. You can still see quite a bit of track. So first up in Fantasyland, Winnie the Pooh there. 25 minute wait. Not too shabby. Next up, we're gonna be checking Mine Train here on the right, which is known for very long wait times. And today, it is 60 minutes. Which still might seem like quite a bit, but is pretty good for Mine Train. And we have a few more attractions to check out over here. But I'll leave the camera on so we can see these crowds as I pass through together. Is it just me, or does the sea of strollers make it look like there's a lot of people when there's not? There's really not a lot of people. Just a lot of strollers. Look at that view. It's a pretty good one. All right, so here we are. Peter Pan's flight at 25 minutes. That's very, very good. Really good. And let's see what Small World is. Well, Small World at 35 minutes, having a longer wait time than Peter Pan. Maybe that's because of how many people they're putting on the boats and how many people they can get through on Peter Pan is still quite good. So I guess that does make a little bit of sense right now. But yeah, even the line though, even though it's only a 25 minute wait, the line looks crazy. But it's really not. 25 is nothing for Peter Pan. But the line, yeah, it looks pretty intense. This is another thing that's been going on for a bit now, but just in case you missed it, I'll point it out. The river here has been drained, and they're doing a whole bunch of construction work down there. I'll get closer, I'll try to get a closer look around the bend here. Then here's a closer look at our river here, filled with vehicles. My immersion is ruined. It's fine. Just imagine how much water, how many gallons of water they had to drain to get this dry and get in there and do this work. So many gallons. What it's like traversing our way through Adventureland. And even though the Christmas decorations are still up, Jungle Cruise has reverted to its regular form of Jungle Cruise, no longer Jingle Cruise. And the wait time for that is right now at 40 minutes. We're gonna turn back around and go back up this path because we're not gonna wait in line for that. What we are gonna do is we're gonna check out the wait time for Pirates as well, which I will note has had longer wait times than some of the other attractions lately. And I think that is the same, for the same reason that Small World might had a longer wait time than Peter Pan. Because of how many people they can actually put on the boats. Again, this is just an assumption of mine. No facts or evidence to really back that up besides, you know, my experience coming here and noticing that Pirates and Small World have tended to have a little bit longer wait times. We'll see what it is today. Before we even got to the time marker though, here's the line for Pirates. This is the line for Pirates, and you can tell it looks pretty intense. Wrapping all the way around like that. But what time do we have posted? And again, I should mention this like I mentioned in all the videos like this one. Wait times aren't necessarily accurate. And in our experience, they are not. Usually the posted wait time is longer than it actually is from our experience. And Pirates posted at 40 minutes. And before we end off today, let's check out these last two mountains, Splash and Thunder, and see what kind of times we got. I can already see ahead right now. Big Thunder Mountain is at 45 minutes. Let's see what Splash is at. Also for reference, because now that we're checking out Splash, it matters a little bit. The temperature today is 70, between 70 and 74. And Splash is rightfully so at 50 minutes. Because this would be a pretty warm day for a lot of people visiting Walt Disney World. So wait, wouldn't mind getting wet. on a day like today.
All right, everybody, that is what's up at Magic Kingdom today. We took a look at crowd levels, wait times, general atmosphere, and construction happenings. If you enjoyed this video, be sure to give it a thumbs up as well. Subscribe for future videos from me and the other Diz team members who uploaded this channel. And I hopefully will see you in the next one.